I'm standing on the edge of the Great North Woods, not far from Greenville, Maine, and Moosehead Lake, a little more than halfway from the equator to the North Pole. Maybe you can tell. We're about to commence a two-day cross-country ski jaunt between two remote lodges operated by the Appalachian Mountain Club. So come on along for the next half hour. We're going to have a lot of fun. Well, at least I hope we are. Welcome to Windows to the Wild. I'm Willem Lange. Today we're at Little Lyford Pond Camps, not too far from Greenville, Maine. This is an old 19th century logging camp, which was converted into a sporting camp and recently purchased and renovated by the Appalachian Mountain Club as a remote forest lodge. I'm here today with my dear old friend, more old than dear, Putt Blodgett from Lyme Center, New Hampshire. Now, we've paddled and skied a few miles together, haven't we, over the years?
About 40 years, I think, Will.
A lot of miles, I guess so.
And we're feeling it now.
We what?
I'm feeling it now.
I see. Well, neither one of us can hear the other, so we talk pretty loud. Let's check in, get our fire going in the camp, and get ready for supper.
I'm even looking forward to that even more.
Okay, good. Let's get them off, Putt.
Okay.
Can you do both skis at once the way I can?
No,
I can't either. There we go. Very nice. Putt, I'll tell you, this is fun. You have to Google Putt to see why he's famous. Vermonter, Dartmouth class of 53, dairy farmer, boys camp owner, tree farmer. Most of all, a terrific friend, even though he hates fishing. Putt and I got ourselves settled in at Little Lyford. We had time to kill before supper, so we walked up to the bathhouse, which has a fantastic sauna in it. Supper time. I've been waiting all day for it. You couldn't ask for a better winter morning, a beautiful sunrise, a gentle breeze, and fresh powder on the ground and the trees. These were very good omens. Well, I don't know why, but our production assistant, Larry, thought it'd be a good time to try his cross-country skis. He'd never tried them before in his life.
First time on cross country skis, so.
First time?
Yeah.
Oh, poor Larry. Before we left Little Lyford, we had a hearty breakfast at the Maine Lodge. But soon we had to put the gear on the sleds and head out. It was either that or haul it on our backs for 6 miles. We put it on the sleds. Looking out those windows, I didn't much want to leave the lodge, even if it was time to get back to work. As Putt was taking the time to wax his skis, I spoke with AMC's Senior Vice President, Walter Graff.
The sauna's nice, the cabins are... You have your... Different from our AMC huts, yeah. In that you have your own cabins.
Yeah.
So you just have to deal with your mate who's snoring. You don't have to deal with 12 other people snoring. So that works out. And you have your own little wood fire, wood stove.
Yep.
And so it's a very different experience, a very relaxing experience. And if you're skiing in, you leave your overnight gear at a shed, and miraculously when you arrive, it appears in your cabin.
That was nice.
And that's
that
nice.
Worked, yes.
So that works out well.
That's great. Well, thank you, Walter.
Okay.
That's terrific.
All right. Thank you very much.
Great. Great. 15 cabins.
I'm glad you're up here. Let me tell you that.
Oh, yeah, me too.
Okay.
Thanks.
I hope you enjoyed breakfast.
Yeah, so great. Great. Great.
Great. Great. And also, I hope you enjoyed your set.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we had an adequate breakfast, would you say?
We've got to ski it off now, because otherwise I can't bend over to tie my shoes.
Quiche and bacon. Oh, God, that was good. Half a gallon of coffee. Now, we got, how many miles we got to go now?
Oh, six.
Six? That's not bad. We can do that in our sleep.
we'll probably be asleep by the time we get there.
Everybody else will. Pod and I were taking the easiest trails to Gorman Chairback. They're the ones colored in green on the map. For us old-time skiers, it was exactly what we needed.
Okay, good. So we might as well tackle it. I guess the first mile or so is fairly level till we get.
Well, that's good. They get loosened up a little before we have to work hard going up or crash going down.
Okay, up I don't mind, but down.
Yeah, down is scary, especially if you have fast skis. I haven't been able to get enough climbing wax on mine yet this morning, so.
Are they pretty fast?
Yeah. Faster than I would like.
Go ahead of me. I don't want you crashing into me.
I intend to be ahead of you because I know you'll crash and I'll want to crash further down the trail.
Skiing the first mile of the trail wasn't bad at all. It was very soothing and flat. Been like this the whole time, Putt and I could have finished in half an hour. Well, maybe not a half hour, but pretty close. All too soon, we came to a hurdle. Well, more like a drop-off.
It looks like one of the Canadian ski marathon hills that say, attention.
Yeah.
Caution.
I remember that big open field where people were spread out all over it, potholes and brush.
Yep.
You survived that, you were lucky.
I've been lucky several times. Come on, you brute. There we go. Beauty.
Now it was Larry's turn to go down the hill.
I'm okay.
Let's just say it was a very long day. But he did manage to get down in one piece. I mean, he fell only six times to my three. could probably ski this hill. I could probably not ski this hill. Get out of there. There. So, discretion being the better part of valor, I'll walk it. Wonderful. Two roads diverged in a wood. I felt as if we were in a Robert Frost poem. Well, we're at one of those inscrutable intersections in the middle of nowhere.
Well, I don't see any ski tracks going that way.
Ah, very
but
good.
But yet there's a sign that says Gorman Chairback that way, so I'd suggest that if that's where we're going, we follow the arrow.
I wish I were as bright as you, Putz.
Well, it took a long time to get there.
But it did. Well, okay, so let's take this one.
Let's follow the arrow to Gorman Chairback.
And also the ski tracks of those who've gone before. So.
I think it makes good sense.
Thank you. After you. Even though I struggled at times with the skiing, I couldn't help but appreciate all that was around me. This wilderness is part of the AMC's Maine Woods Initiative, of which Walter Graff was chief architect.
The Maine Woods Initiative started just 10 years ago. In November would be 10 years.
Yep.
We have huts in the Wide Mountains, mm-hmm. and members came out and said, you know, could you build more huts somewhere? Can you do something like that? And we said, well, that's an idea. We'll try that. So we looked all across from New York to Vermont, New Hampshire, Maine, and we came up with this thought that this is a big idea, and it needs a big place. And where's the big place? Maine. So we looked for land that was conserved already that we could add to, and the Appalachian Trail came right through this property.
That's right.
So we stepped up and we bought first 37,000 acres, then we bought another 30,000 acres.
How do you just step up and buy 37,000? I couldn't do that.
Well, stepping up was, maybe it's more diving off, diving off into some deep water.
Yeah.
And our board was supportive of it, we knew our members would be supportive of it, and we wanted to do something different. We wanted to... All our properties, all our facilities in the White Mountains are national forest land.
Yep.
And we said, is there a way a nonprofit could do something like this? Could a nonprofit buy a large section of large piece of property and create a recreational corridor, protect wildlife, but also lift up a community? So it's really the Greenville community, surrounding Brownville, these communities needed kind of an anchor, I think, that would create some backcountry recreations. And then we have an education component, too, where we're working with local schools. And so Monday, we're closed actually Monday for the season, but the schools are coming in, and they're going to snowshoe in and spend the night. And some of these kids locally, you know, they don't get to enjoy the outdoors.
That's right.
They don't know the outdoors because they're living their lives.
I must say, I got to hand it to the AMC for offering these opportunities for everybody to enjoy. This the way to Bangor? Putz never been afraid to push to his limits. God, I hope when I'm his age, I can have that chutzpah. But then I found there was a reason behind his madness.
I'm scared of falling. I don't know whether I'll get up now in this old age obsession of ours.
Yeah, it's a pain, but consider the alternative.
Well, I think this proves that if you keep going and take it easy, why, as I The old saying, use it or lose it. I said that to my mother one time when she was sitting in the chair by the stove, and she snapped right back at me and said, use it and abuse it, son.
It ain't easy getting old. Well, unless you're putt. When we got close to Gorman Chairback, we rendezvoused with my good friend Shannon Leroy, the programs manager of the Maine Woods Initiative. One of the programs she's helped create is outdoor education in the Moosehead area for children of all ages. On this part of the trail, for example, the outdoor classes will not only snowshoe, but they'll learn forestry, too.
The last class we had in, we had the Belgian horses logging outside of Gorman, and we took them over to watch the Belgian horses pulling logs out of the woods. And the kids were amored about it. They just loved it. And the loggers were gracious enough to stop and talk to the kids and tell them what they were doing and let them come up and pet the horses. And I think it really made a difference with these kids because they realized that you don't have to use machinery, you don't have to harvest lots and lots and lots, but what we do in our harvesting is we harvest specific trees for specific reasons to make a better forest, a more diverse type forest. Conservation is one of our core pieces, and so if we bring the kids out and teach them about what's important outside, what the outside is all about, so that we can build some stewardship in these kids so when they get to be adults, they understand the need for taking care of the woods and the water.
Having Shannon there really motivated us to get to the finish. We were nearly there. Dear, looks as though we made it. There it was, Gorman Chairback. Not exactly Neuschwanstein Castle, maybe, but after skiing all day, it seemed like it to us. We'd finally made it. I'll believe it when I feel that warm air. But this has been a nice day.
It has been a nice day. What a joy.
Thanks for the company.
Temperature's been good. Oh, you're very welcome.
Thanks for bringing the first aid kit.
You're welcome for that, too.
All right. We get these things off.
Time for...
But way ahead of us. I don't
snack,
know why.
Some he coffee took and maybe a sauna, huh?
I think he's... Oh, that would be nice,
there
yeah.
There you go.
I think Putt must have smelled the barn. Off he went.
He's got the coffee, I'm sure.
All right, so we'll go in, get warm, have a cup of coffee, and a sauna. Yes.
So first. All righty.
And tomorrow, we'll go on out of here.
Tomorrow, it's on the way out. You can ski the lake tomorrow. Finally.
Oh, really?
Your wish come true.
Good.
All right.
I want it to. Putt, what happened to you?
Oh, my skis went stick, so I just slid along.
Just like Little Lyford, Gorman Camps was formerly a sporting camp that was purchased by the AMC. The cabins here were renovated and the main lodge built new. Inside, you can still smell the fresh-cut logs. It's much bigger than Little Lyford, making more room for rest and relaxation. Most of the lodges feel new, but one down by the pond is pretty old. It's built in the shape of an octagon. It was built by a one-armed Civil War veteran, William Dean, and his 10-year-old son. They couldn't lift logs long enough for a four-side cabin, so they built an eight-sided one instead. Imagine how hard it must have been. But it paid off. It's beautiful. And it's lasted. Done.
Yes, I think the days of hunkering down in a little tent with wet clothes and trying to cook at the end of the day are long gone as far as I'm concerned. And
don't you
coming into a fantastic hut like this and having food prepared and a table to eat off and a fire to dry your clothes by. I think that's the way I want to live from now on.
You don't miss the good old days. You remember that time you took your little tiny tent and you always gave me the windward side, and every time the wind blew it would...
Well, I mean, when I was next to you, the wind blows anyway, Willem.
So. Well, we had a good day. We had a great feast that night. Afterward, I was so tired and full of good food that I skipped a party in one of the cabins. But I'm sure they got along fine without me. Putt was right. Our good old days of camping with wet clothes in a wet tent are over. Being in beautiful natural surroundings, sleeping in a cozy cabin with your clothes drying by the fire, eating delicious food, taking a nice sauna and shower afterward, that is the life. And sharing the experience with my good friend Putt made it all the better. But to quote another Robert Frost poem, nothing gold can stay. Putt and I had to get our stuff on the snowmobile soon before heading back home. I'm going to miss this place, but I'll be back. Even if the temperatures were below freezing most of the time, we had optimal skiing conditions, and the cabins kept us nice and warm. Everybody had a great time, me and Putt included.
We've about come to the end of our great adventure, eh?
Well, it's been a great experience.
Yeah.
Good snow during the day to ski on, and warm cabins at night, and good company in the main lodge, and good food, and when we have the chance for easy living, let's take it.
Yeah, yeah, good thinking. Well, today there's a little air stirring up high in the tops of those pine trees.
Yep.
We got a change coming.
Yep.
That's for better or worse, I don't know, but it's coming.
Let's ski with the wind.
Good idea. We could.
A good tailwind will push us along.
So let's end our journey. We'll take off back to the parking lot.
Yeah.
Pick up the truck and go home, okay?
It's been a good experience.
Yeah, it's about time to... We've had fun, now it's time to get back to work.
Oh,
wouldn't
God.
You say? I hope to see you all again on Windows to the Wild. I'm Willem Lange.
Support for the production of Windows to the Wild has been provided by the Alice J. Reen Charitable Trust, the Fuller Foundation, the Mount Washington Cog Railway, and from viewers like you. Thank you.